हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो या वी हैव इनफ स्ट्रेंथ सो वी कैन स्टार्ट। लेट मी जस्ट हैव अ लुक इनटू द टॉपिक वेयर वी वर लेफ्ट। ओके, या सो guys, before we will start this, just wanted to ask you guys, like, do you have any doubt or means any queries regarding, you know, whatever we have learned so far? Guys, please do let me know if you have any concern, any issue, please, because, you know, today only itself in the morning I have spoken with your, you know, principal sir, as well as what we call as your HOD sir. So they are pretty much fine with what exactly we have taught you, and they are, you know, they want me to still continue till this month or maybe, you know, few days of the next month. So I don't know, so that is why, you know, I keep on covering almost everything. When I say everything, that doesn't mean like means I'm covering an entire thing. But yeah, so whatever necessary things which I found, like, it is actually important for you all, for everyone, that all things I'm gonna, you know, cover. So please do let me know if at all you guys feel like, no, this topic I haven't understood and this topic need to be, you know, revised kind of thing or whatever. It depends on you how exactly you wanted to frame your question, or you wanted to, you know, ask you something from me. And even I had a discussion regarding, you know, test. So he's saying like, okay, you can take test. So I don't know when I'm gonna take, but I will take that test. And your test, one of the tests, you can say like your exam will be going to happen after, you know, this month, or maybe, you know, next, mid of next month, you can say, probably mid of next month, but yeah, I'm still not sure. So guys, that's why I keep on saying you guys, like, please focus on this, you know, entire curriculum, or maybe you can say the entire course, because even we have spoken. So he said like, if you found 5 to 10 students out of entire strength, means 70 strength, he said, if you found 10 to 15 students, probably to whom you can take it as an industry exposure, so you can take it. So I'm not sure still. So I'm not sure about like how you guys are doing with, you know, this coding stuff and, you know, Python programming. But I'll assure you guys, if you are good enough, you know, so me and your principal sir will try our best to, you know, get into the industry in the beginning itself, or maybe you can get some sort of exposure from the industry, maybe 6 months or maybe probably 3 to 4 months, and you will get some sort of a stipend from it. So guys, it's a very important, you know, topic which I would like to discuss with you guys, and that is what I have discussed actually. And this you know, this kind of thing has happened today morning itself. So maybe still we need to, you know, do some sort of compilation before going any, you know, further for, you know, exposure, industry exposure. So still I need 10 to 5, 15 students who are really very good, you know, in this stuff, whatever I have taught, whatever, you know, they have listened. So entire thing is depend on those aspects only. And, you know, if I'm going to take some test, then most probably you have to perform better. Okay, great. So somebody has said understood. Okay, thank you so much for that. Now, apart from that, I just wanted to know one more thing. How do you guys feel about, you know, this entire course? Truly speaking, please share your feedback with me. Like, are you doing good in this exam, sorry, in this entire subject, or you are really, you know, okay. So few people are started pinging me, cool sir, nice classes, thank you so much. Okay, but because it is very important for you all to, you know, give your most of the focus on this programming stuff and you know in this kind of activity or maybe you can say like this particular subject. Why I'm trying to emphasize this, because you are basically from computer science background. If you are very good and you know good in programming, then nobody can stop you to achieve whatever you wanted to achieve. Okay, that I can even assure that. Even we want people who are very good in coding stuff. So that is why I used to say like, please, please, please give some focus, provide your, you know, time to this subject and do something from it. Okay, this is nothing but a small lecture from my side, because morning we had a, you know, very long conversation with, you know, with your, you can say principal and dean. So, yep. Now let me see where we were into the, you know, Jupyter notebook so that I can, you know, start further. Oops, my bad. Let me share my screen with you all. Okay. Yep. Now here we are, LGEST we have learned, and what was that? Okay. So as I spoken with you all in the last time, what I was covered is LGEST is for what? This is nothing but the left justifies a string in a field, and by default padding consists of ASCII space character. Okay, that is what I have told you guys. And here I have written, you know, LGEST 10, given one example for LGEST 10, and then LGEST 3 also I have written. So guys, just wanted to know from you all, if I will ask a simple question from you, if I will write this, okay, this much, let's say this entire example, do you think if I will give 4-5 questions, you know, maybe 2 questions, couple of questions with the same, are you guys will be able to do this or not? Okay, let me perform like this. I'm giving spaces. What does that mean? Are we getting something? Yes, that is being, you know, space already present. Okay. And what does that mean? If I will give spaces here as well, we are getting both side spaces. So nothing has been changed here. Okay. So we are pretty much clear with, you know, what we have learned so far. And now let me move on to the next. And by default, padding consists of ASCII space character. Yep. Now, string formatting, which, you know, we are talking from the last, you can say last 1 or 2 days. And, you know, it's pretty much, even I can say like, it's pretty much a huge subject, or you can say like huge topic, because you know there are a lot many things are present in, you know, string, where we need to know each and everything, and somewhere maybe after some time even I used to forget, you know, a lot of methods, but I know by the name only you can interpret what exactly it is trying to say, and that is how we keep on remembering the things. So that is why I'm saying you guys, please focus on this stuff. Okay, and now here again I have specified, I don't know, after justifies I'm gonna cover L strip and R strip. What is L strip and R strip? So I don't know, means everybody would be able to see this. Okay, presentation. Yeah, everybody will be able to see. Now here, suppose you wanted to, first of all let me just give a definition. Trim leading character from a string, it returns a copy of the string by removing any white spaces character from the left end. So if I am specifying here L strip, let's say, okay, if I'm specifying L strip, then what is gonna happen here? Tell me. If I will specify L strip, that means it is going to return whatever the string I had earlier. It will remove the white spaces if at all that is present. Okay. And if I will ask you have to perform R strip, then it is gonna remove all the white spaces character from the right hand side. Okay, so that is what it's L and R. Okay, and we can have another, you know, optional argument which we can say, like, which is, you know, it is a kind of a string where exactly we can specify some sort of, you know, characters. And maybe I used to specify somewhere because I wanted to remove something. Let's say I wanted to remove something from the string, then I would like to specify that particular, you know, character into that argument. So let me take these two examples and let me, you know, clear you all what exactly we have spoken and what exactly you have received. So I'll take one by one each example, because this is, you know, I have created these examples for you guys. So please pay attention actually. Now, here what exactly it is. So here when I say, here you can see here, we have a lot of white spaces. Here in left side also, we have lot of spaces, white spaces, and here in the right side also. Now let me run this. You can see the left-hand side spaces has been removed, okay? But right-hand side spaces is still persist, okay? So if I would like to remove that, so let me right-hand side spaces, then let me write the same statement, but instead of using L, I'm gonna use R. Let me see. You can see we are trying to remove here white spaces, so we are, you know, successfully removed that, and now here is still left hand side is persist. Okay, now let me write, instead of this, let me write this statement. Let me write this. We will see. Yeah. Now, you can see if I will write dot strip, then it is going to remove all the white spaces. Okay. Whatever, wherever white spaces present in our string. Now, if I will write only R or L, then it is going to, you know, remove white spaces only to the that end. Okay. So please, just for you guys, please remember this, because it's a pretty much, you know, self-explanatory. Like L is there, that means it is left strip, and it is right strip. And if I will mention a strip, that means it is gonna remove from everywhere, every places. Now, let me just use the optional argument which I was talking about. We have one string which is saying like this, which is having like this. So now this string contains what? Let's say I'm talking about this string. This string contains what? Let me specify here what exactly this string is. So I have written a string chow. There is chow, then there is dot, then there is at the rate, dot, at the rate. Then there we have another, you know, comma as well. So we have enough thing into the string. I really don't want all these stuff. I just want what all the string is present. Instead of this character, sorry, instead of this special character, or maybe dot, or maybe comma. I really don't want, and I really don't care about that. So how I'm gonna remove that? So that you can do using this. So that is where, when I said this is nothing but the optional argument. Okay, so I am going to specify something inside into this argument. So I have specified at the rate, I have specified comma, I have specified dot. I don't need these. So if I will run, what I am going to get? So I need your answers. Please write down in message box. I'll be back in just 2 minutes or 2 seconds. थैंक यू सो मच. ओके 558 यू आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, 570 यू आर आल्सो समवॉट क्लोज टू दैट, देन 528 यू हैव यू नो यू हैवंट रिटन द आंसर दो यू आर सेइंग एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग. 5C4 आई डोंट नो व्हाट रोल नंबर इज इट, बट या यू आर आल्सो समवॉट करेक्ट, नॉट समवॉट यू आर करेक्ट. So let me run this and let me see what exactly it is. Okay, ciao. So now, why we are looking into this kind of exercise? Why we need this R strip, S strip, and all? Why? Do you think why we need? Can anybody can have a guess? Just want simple liner of explanation. So nobody is trying to give answer. Okay, now suppose you have few things. When I say suppose, you are running one industry, let's say, or maybe you can say like you assume your college, your entire college. Now in your college there are so many faculties or maybe so many students, okay, and the college wanted to provide you the email address of all the faculty, all the students as well. Now you may get your email ID is as in ravikiran@chbr.com, let's say this is what your email address. Now there are many people who got these kind of addresses, email addresses you can say. Now out of it, suppose your HOD sir wanted to know all the names instead of their Gmail address. Maybe they already have that. So you guys have registered by your own and in their database, they have just gotten your what email address. They haven't received your, what is that? They haven't received your basically name, let's say. Now, few people might have, created their mail ID with the different name, or maybe you can say like they might have created some useless name. But generally, if your college people will ask you to create your, college mail address, then most of them are going to create it like name followed with, roll number and then your surname or whatever. Means it's a combination of both, maybe you can say. Okay. So that is how, so that everybody would be able to recognize that. Now, after that kind of exercise, now HOD want just name. So now they are not going to be in touch with you all and they will say like, no, you have to provide your name. That is not gonna possible. So how exactly it is going to be possible is once he had received in his database, let's say maybe you guys are maintaining Oracle or maybe some sort of DB, maybe Microsoft, you can say, then everybody's mail is already there. Then I just wanted to run this kind of, strip or maybe R strip, you can say, or maybe L strip, whatever. It depends on you, what you are trying to say. So if I will write like this, so I will write, let's say I have written here, Ravi Kiran. Ravi, let's say Ravi has created something, some sort of, 78 or maybe @, or I must say Ravi Kiran only, Kiran @ CHBR. Yeah, this is what the roll number, let's say, right? Mail address. Now I want only a strip. I need only what your name. So I will write here CHBR. So what would be the output? So I will get only Ravi Kiran. Why R is not coming up? Okay, because R I am trying to remove from here. So you have to tackle that as well. Okay, so @CHBR. So you are getting your first name, that's it. Okay, so this is how your requirement comes to you. And maybe, maybe few, IP addresses contains @, I guess. or maybe some you know, when you deal some logs, you will get the log contains some junky data. So we were trying to remove that junky data using with the, or maybe you can say with the help of a strip, because we are pretty much aware about what all characters are gonna come into that, you know, entire maybe entire data. So we will just write this kind of, you know, statement, or maybe we will try to use this kind of method to get rid of those special characters which we are not gonna use later point of time as well. So this is where we can use that. Okay, now even I have mentioned here optional char argument is specified, and it is a string that specifies the set of characters to be removed. Now we will talk about what exactly str replace. What is replace? What does replace then? You might have, you know, I don't know how many of you use this. Find and replace. This is, you know, if you will open your maybe Word, Microsoft Word, or maybe Excel, you will find this kind of, you know, one pop-up comes up by saying like what you want to find, and you, when you find that, you do you really want to replace it with something else? Suppose my, you know, somewhere I have used your college name for one article. Let's say means your article has been, your college article has been published and many times, maybe, you know, let's say in 1,000 word or maybe 1,000 lines, your name comes around, you know, maybe you can say like 500 times, let's say. Now I am not gonna go manually going to change that name, or maybe trying to replace your college name with, you know, your university name. No, what I will write simple program to replace wherever you find the college name with the university name. So that is the simple, you can say, example. And this kind of example generally we people try to use when we deal with any case study. So it's a pretty much straightforward, okay, which you, where you don't need to do, you know, multiple things, but yeah, you can do small stuff using these kind of methods. Okay, now when we talk about replace only, okay, so in replace, you can say it is used to replace, this method is being used to replace the occurrence of a substring within a string, maybe multiple times. As I said, ch bar is a part of that entire string which is of 1000 lines, you can say. So now I just wanted to replace that string, which string? That is your college name string, and I wanted to replace it with what? With your university name, let's say. Okay, so this is how actually you need to, you know, perform various tasks in case of replace. So now in replace, if you will look into the method which I am currently showing you, I have written old. When I say, that means the string which you wanted to replace, and new is nothing but the string which by which you want to replace the old string. That means this one is my previous string, now this one is my new string. So suppose your college name has to be replaced with your university name. So college name will come here in old, and then new, nothing but the your you know, university name should be coming here in the place of new. Okay, and then count, I will talk about that also. When exactly the count is being used. So here I have mentioned it is used to replace, which is pretty much clear. Now count, optional argument is specified, the maximum of count replacements are performed. Okay, so there, now here if you will see, I have mentioned here the count is nothing but the optional argument, and the maximum of count is replacements are being performed. That means if I will mention two, okay, then two places only you need to replace this new string. or maybe new item, whatever you say. Okay, so now let us perform that. So now you can see here, I am gonna take this example, which is pretty much simple and, you know, pretty much self-explanatory. So I would like to go to the Jupyter notebook so that you guys can able to understand this example. So let me write here, replace. Now, here my string is bar chow chow bar meow fo. So please don't go into the what string sir is writing. Please, I whatever comes in my mind, I write like this. So don't worry. Okay, it doesn't have any string, because if I will write any sort of a string and maybe it becomes some contradictory, then it would be a problem. So I don't want to write kind of that kind of string. But yeah. Pretty much simple, because I wanted to, you know, cover few things, so that is why I kept like this. Now what is saying is replace what? Replace bar with bow. Yeah, have you seen here there is any bow? No. Now we want to replace this bar with bow. Okay, that is what it is. Now let me run this. Anyone want to have any guess? Okay, let me run first, and then later on second question I will ask like this. You can see instead of bar we are getting bow. Here also bar we are getting bow. Nothing else has been changed. Okay, so this is pretty much clear. So now guys, if I will modify some sort of, you know, this, let me modify some part of that string. Here, suppose I would like to write multiple places bar. Okay, here also I have written bar. Here also I'm gonna write bar. Now, I need to replace bar with bow. Okay, that is fine. Pretty much understandable. Now, I don't want to be replaced everywhere. I just want to be replaced, though bar is appeared here 4 times. 2, 3, 4. I want to be replaced only two times. Okay, let me use this optional argument. So here I'm gonna specify two, the count. Let me run this. Now you can see this bar is gonna replace with bow. This bar is again gonna replace with bow. Here our bar is extremely or exactly similar to the previous. You can see. Okay, so you can say the optional argument is pretty much useful, because if suppose you already aware about like only 2-3 places my, you know, this string is being changed, I really want to change only 2-3 places. Now you just need to specify like these 2-3 places I just need to change it. So that is where basically you can use the replace. Okay, now what else we can cover on replace? So basically you can interpret it as first find this and then replace this. So here we need to find bar and then we have to replace bow. So you can correlate this entire method with the find method. So if I will write here find, the find will work as in bar. Okay, you don't need to specify bow and to whatever. Okay, so yesterday we had a discussion about find method as well. So guys, I don't know whether you guys have remember or you just keep on forgetting everything. If that is the case, then please do let me know, because there is a problem. Now let me cover to the next topic, where I'm using Zfill. What is Zfill? Okay. Z field is nothing but it's a generally it pads a string on the left, okay, on the left with zero characters to the specified width. Okay, now I wanted to pad some zeros on the left side, then I will be able to specify that. Okay, so how are we going to do that? We can specify using Z field. What it basically does is it is going to pad a string on the left with what? With zero character to the specified width. So when I say specified width, that is nothing but the parameter which you wanted to give. Okay, so here in my example, I have clearly mentioned 3. 3 is nothing but my specified width. Okay, so this is what you can say my specified width. So it is what it is going to do here in this method. If suppose I am writing 98.z field and I am specifying 3, what it is going to do? Okay, what exactly it is gonna do? So guys, do one thing. I am gonna write this particular statement or a string, you can say, on my notebook, and then you guys can perform, and please ping me over the Zoom chat what exactly output you guys are getting. Okay, so let me write in this manner. Here I'm gonna write 98, and here I'm gonna write this kind of a string, and I need to perform this. Now I want you all to provide me the output. Okay, please, quickly. Guys, I'm keeping myself in a mute. Please provide answer. So what exactly the output you guys are getting is okay, a few people are correct, or okay. I don't know, many of you, I am getting responses that is pretty much, you know, thank you so much for quick responses. Just let me see what exactly the output. So you know, multiple people, or you can say like many of them have given the correct output. So thank you so much, 556, 570, 520. Thank you so much. These people have got the correct answer. Okay. So, guys, let us perform something else. Okay. Here. Okay. Anybody would like to, you know, ask why we got 098? Just if you have some sort of curiosity, please do let me know. Okay. If you guys are still, you know, feel like, no, sir, we need more examples. So let me write in this manner. I'm gonna write here instead of 3, let me write 5. What supposed to get our answer? You can see here. So it is gonna pad 0 from where? So even in my, you know, even my even if you will look into my definition, which I have clearly gave it to you, that it is gonna specify this with what? It is gonna pad from the left hand side. But five, when I specify, that entire thing has to be five. So whatever it is gonna pad. So it is taking as this entire thing as in five. So we need to pad something till the five is of my length. So we need to fill, or we need to pad this with that many characters of zero, or maybe you can say like that many zeros. Okay. So that is where, when I mention here three, that is why I found only one zero here. Okay. Let me do some messy thing with this. Now I'm going to write this. Let me write negative value. Will it work or not? I'm going to write inside this five, minus five. How many of you are saying it will work? How many are saying it will not work? See, if I will write negative, then it is not gonna work. Okay, it is not gonna listen. Okay, it will return whatever, you know, string you are trying to pass, it will return the same string. Okay, now if I will look into the next topic, let me share you the my screen, or maybe my presentation, you can see. Here we are gonna cover in this topic, converting between the string and list. How the conversion will take place here is, you can see, we generally use this when we need to convert between a string and some sort of composite data type. When I say composite data type, so if you will look into the definition of the definition which I have written, generally we use this conversion when we have to convert between the string and some sort of composite data type. And when I ask you the guys, what is composite data type, anybody got any sort of point what exactly the composite data type is? Guys, it's a list. I don't know, still your mind is not getting strike that kind of, I don't know, but yeah, think about it. Okay, somewhat, then only we will, you know, work on it. So some composite data type, by pasting objects together to make a string, or by breaking a string up into the pieces. Okay, I'll tell you by giving example, this definition, what definition tells. And these method returns what? Iterable. And generally it works with the iterable. Now I am pretty much sure and I'm confident about it, you guys must have forgotten what is iterable. So guys, because of this topic only, I have given, you can say, like half hour lecture on the iterable. So that is why I keep on saying, like, my entire lecture and my entire flow, or maybe you can say like whatever the topic I'm going to cover, it is somehow somehow related to each other. So when I say it is quite related to each other, that means if I have, you know, spoken about something, if I have taken some topic, that topic is gonna be used somewhere in your past, or maybe somewhere in your future. Okay, so please always, you know, think about that, how exactly I am trying to correlate the topic which I have already covered with the topic which currently I am covering. Okay, so these are all things which you need to cover. Because if I'm gonna give, I'm gonna take exam of you guys, then definitely I'm gonna ask something from this, because I have already covered iterable, and now I'm gonna cover what is the use basically, you know, in larger view if you will see what is the use of this. Okay, now if you will see here, I have given one example. Okay, first of all, you just need to know how exactly we can write the method. So here we can write, I'm writing here, the string has to join with iterable. So iterable consists maybe list, maybe tuple. Okay, so here I'm gonna use some list. Okay, so let me tell you here what it does. So first let me cover join method. Okay, join method, the syntax is pretty much simple. It is nothing but the string which you wanted to pass and then dot join, and then you have to pass what exactly you wanted to join. Okay, now here I have clearly mentioned it will return the string after concatenating the objects in iterable. So if you will see, these are the objects, because this is entire list, and in list what exactly? List contains objects. So what it does, it is gonna concatenate the object in iterable separated by str. So separated by str, when I say, that means separated by the string. Okay, so here I am passing this str. So let me take this basically to the Jupyter notebook, and then I will show you what exactly I was talking about. So we are trying to cover now conversion. Basically, we are doing converting string and list, let's say. My example is like this. Okay. Now, instead of double quote, you should mention just single quote. That is also fine. Yeah. Now, before we start this, let me just explain you about, sorry, let me tell you, I hope everybody will be able to see my this screen. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So first of all, let me just again talk about list. Okay. So that you guys can understand and able to correlate. Now I am writing here name, something name, names, and this is nothing but the list, and I'm going to write this. Now, if I will write this, I wanted to print what is there in my list. I'm writing here names. If you will see, what would be the output? We are getting list in this manner. So we are getting whatever we have written here. That is same exactly we will be getting. Now, what I want my output to be, instead of this, I want my output should be look like, this, and then there must be some space, and there must be after this some space, okay, like this. So that is why I use this. Let me see how exactly we can get here. You can see here earlier what was my output. You can see we are getting list here. I want that list has to be converted into the string, and this string will be like this. So here after the comma, I want some gap. Here after the comma, I want some gap. If you want no gap, then you should remove this. And now you run this. You can see like, we won't get that kind of space. So, but always better to give some space. Okay. So now what I have done, I have converted this particular list into the string. Using what? Using join. Okay. So are we clear or not? I guess hope everybody would be able to clear about it. Now let me go back to the, you know, one more example which I have clearly mentioned here. Here I have written list. Okay, let me write this. This is good. One of the good example you can say. So another example which I have taken, I just wanted to write here list, and then let me write here PKS. You know what does that refer? PKS is Praveen Kumar Singh. So guys, please bear with me. Anyway, I have written like this. Let me run this. What should be the output? I am getting output like this. Now I want something else instead of this. I want my output should be as an string where we will get something else apart from this. I'm going to write here this, let me see, dot join, and I will write here what? PKS. Now, what should be the output? Let me run this. Now you can see, earlier we had one string, one list where we used to get the thing like this. Now I wanted to perform join and I wanted to give, you know, this. And now we are getting PKS like this. So, you know, I don't know, means many, many times, even I have used so many times, you can say, when we used to perform, you know, the basic operation, when I say, when you are doing data messaging, okay. When you are trying to, you know, play with your data, okay, you wanted to format your string, okay, maybe you need to convert your list or maybe some other data type into the string, okay, then these kind of, you know, method plays a very crucial role, because if you will get direct list, then it might be the possibility you won't be able to think about what I am going to do with that list. Then you should convert into the string. Then maybe you can apply some logic on the same. So guys, now this is where actually, you know, you need to understand what method is being applied where. Okay. Now, let me share my new screen and let me write like this. And now I have another method called as partition. Okay, what partition does is it divides the string based on the separator. So partition is here, I have mentioned clearly. What is the syntax? We need to specify first of all a string, and then we have to call dot partition method. And it will take one argument, which is nothing but the separator. Okay. So what it does, it basically divide your string into whatever multiple part you can say based on the separator. And it will return three part tuple, which consists of what? So I have written each and every part. So the part of str preceding separator, the separator itself, and the part of str following. What does that mean is, let me take these two example. And let me share my Jupyter notebook with you all. And let me write this example. Now, what it is going to do? Anybody has any guess? I said in the definition, it is going to partition. It is going to partition into some partition. I don't know how many partition it is going to do. But based on what? Based on something I have specified here. So based on dot. Okay. Okay. Before this, let me, you know, do by default what exactly it takes. If I will write same thing, same example here, over here, and let me write like this. Partition, it is saying, it is throwing an error. Partition takes exactly one argument. And here I haven't passed any argument. That means we need to pass something to the argument to whom, to what we basically do the partition. So here I have a specified dot. That means whatever string is present inside this, I need to do the partition based on what? Based on the dot. So what it will return, we will look. You can see here, we are getting chow, okay. We are getting dot, we are getting meow. So that is what it is saying. This is the separator which comes in the mid, and before the separator, whatever pub coming that comes first, after the separator, whatever comes, that comes at the next. That means this output are we going to get. Now tell me what exactly it is. So guys, I don't know how many of you are, I just wanted to check with you all what exactly this output, in which form exactly this output is in. Wow, thank you so much 558. I want more answer from others. Thank you so much 558. You are really great. Now others, please specify. Okay, 520, thank you so much. You are also correct. Guys, others are sleeping or what? Others are, I guess, sleeping. I haven't received any other, you know, messages. I got three messages out of three. I have received two correct answers. Please, guys, respond. I need some responses. No? Okay. This is nothing but the tuple. That is why I keep on saying, like, please listen properly in my class. So this is nothing but the tuple. And same thing I have spoken when I was explaining about the definition, or maybe I was talking about regarding definition. Okay. Now this has been done. Now, okay. Now, can I get, you know, some sort of I want to know one more thing from you all. Let me write this. Here I will let here what I supposed to do is, let's see, if we do not, we are not going to specify here any dot, and I am trying to specify here dot, what output are we going to expect, or what our output we will get? See, so here I have specified dot, but in my string we do not have dot. People are saying Python screen is not visible. How come? I have shared. Guys, just look here. I have mentioned dot inside the Python partition argument, and in my string there is no dot. What it returns? It returns nothing but my string. Along with that, we will get two more empty kind of string. Okay. So with this, I just would like to, you know, end of my session. Please do let me know if you have any confusion on the very next class. Okay. So thank you so much for the participation. Thank you so much for the people who keep on giving the answers. With this, thank you so much.